गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे इज़ अवर मॉड्यूल 4 ऑफ द सेम चैप्टर रैशनल नंबर. दिस इज़ अवर लेक्चर 4. टुडे वी विल डू फॉलोइंग टॉपिक सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ रैशनल नंबर. विल कंटिन्यू एक्सरसाइज 1C फॉर दैट एंड वी विल स्टडी अबाउट सम प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एडिशन ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स. नाउ Let us see some special cases for subtraction. First one, when 0 is subtracted from a rational number. Let us take an example. Negative 2 upon 3, this is a rational number and 0 is subtracted from it. When negative 2 upon 3 minus 0, the same number will come. Similarly, if we will take a positive rational number, like 4 upon 5 and subtract 0 from that, again the same rational number we will get. So, whenever 0 is subtracted from a rational number, then the same rational number is the answer. Now, the second case, when rational number is subtracted from 0, like example, negative 2 upon 3 from 0. So, the equation will become like this, 0 minus bracket mein negative 2 upon 3, this negative and negative will become positive. So, this will become 0 plus 2 upon 3 and here is the answer. Similarly, if we'll take a positive rational number and it is subtracted from 0, the equation will become like this, 0 minus 4 upon 5. When we will solve this, we'll get negative 4 upon 5. So, you have to remember, when any rational number is subtracted from 0, then answer is additive inverse of a given number. Answer is always additive inverse of a given number. This you have to remember. Now, let us do some questions of exercise 1C. This is question number 7, part 2. The part is negative 5 upon 6 is to be subtracted from 1 upon 3. So, our equation will become like this. 1 upon 3 minus, because it is a negative number, we will make a bracket here. Negative 5 upon 6. So, the negative and negative will become positive. And we will solve as we have done in the addition. And our answer will be 7 upon 6. Because it is a improper fraction, so we will convert this into a mixed fraction and write our answer as this. Now let us do the next part. Third part, negative 8 upon 9 is subtracted from negative 3 upon 5. Here both the numbers are negative. So our equation will be negative 3 upon 5 minus negative 8 upon 9. Here again negative and negative will become positive here. And this is our next equation. Now here, LCM of 5 and 9 is 45 and we will solve our numerator like 5 is to be multiplied by which number to get 45? Yes, it is 9. So, we will multiply its numerator by the same number. Here we will see 9 is multiplied by which number so that we can get 45? That is 5. So, we will multiply numerator by the same number. Here after solving we will get this equation. And after solving this is our answer. Now let us do the next part. Here negative 9 upon 7 is subtracted from negative 1. So this is the equation, negative 1 minus negative 9 upon 7. Again, minus and minus will become plus, and here because denominator is not there, so we will write here 1. And LCM of 1 and 7, LCM of 1 and 7 is 7 only. And we will see 1 is to be multiplied by which number so that we can get 7. That is 7. So, we will multiply its numerator by 7. Like this. Here we have done. And then we will see the 7 is multiplied by which number? That is 1. So, we will multiply its numerator by 1. And this is the next equation. And this is the answer we will get after solving. Now, let us do some word problem from the same exercise 1C. This is question number 7. This is question number 11 of the same exercise. Now, next question is question number 11 of the same exercise. The question is, what number should be added to negative 5 upon 8 so as to get negative 3 upon 2 as an answer? Now, we have to find out the number which is to be added to this rational number. Now, let us suppose the required number is x. Now, we will make the equation. Like, negative 5 upon 8 is to be added to which number? That is x, to get this as an answer. Now, we will solve this equation. Now, by transposition, this negative 5 upon 8 will move to right hand side and become positive. On the right hand side and left hand side, there is a x. Now, again, this is the same situation as we are adding the two rational numbers. Here, the denominators are different. So, we will take the LCM of 2 and 8, that is 8. Now, we will add these two. Now, again, we will see the 2 is multiplied by which number so that we can get 8. So, that is 4. So, we will multiply the numerator by the same number. Here we will see the 8 is to be multiplied by which number? That is 1. So we will multiply the numerator by the same number. The next equation we will get x as a negative 12 plus 5 upon 8 after solving. And when we will solve this, we will get negative 7 upon 8 as an answer for x. And this is our required number. So, here we will write negative 7 upon 8 is the required number. This is our answer. Now, next question. Now, we will do question number 13. The question is, what number should be subtracted? Now, we have to subtract the number from this negative 2 upon 3. To get negative 1 upon 6 as an answer. Again, we have to suppose the number, the required number which we have supposed, that is x. Now, according to the question, the equation will become like this. Now, a number is to be subtracted. So, we will subtract x from the given rational number. Negative 2 upon 3 minus x will become negative 1 upon 6. This is our required equation. Now, again by transposition, we will get negative x is equal to negative 1 upon 6 plus 2 upon 3. When this negative 2 upon 3 will move on right hand side, this will become positive. Now, here is the situation when two rational numbers are to be added. So, we will solve the right hand side like this, as we have done in the previous questions. Here we will add two rational numbers and get negative x as this equation. And after solving it, we will get negative x as 1 upon 2. Now, this is the value of negative x. This is the value of negative x. How to make it positive? We will multiply both sides by negative 1. Like this, we have done and get x as a negative 1 upon 2. So, this is our required number. Now, let us start properties of addition of rational number. Our first property is closure property, which says that the sum of two rational number is always a rational number. Suppose A upon B and C upon D are our two rational numbers, then A upon B plus C upon D is also a rational number. Now let us understand this with an example. Here we have taken A upon B as negative 5 upon 12 and C upon D as a negative 1 upon 4. Now let us add these two rational number. Here we are adding. After adding, we get negative 2 upon 3 as an answer. We have solved this as a similar manner which we have done in the earlier question. Now our answer is negative 2 upon 3. This is also a rational number. So when we add two rational number, then answer is also a rational number. This is the first property. Now let us do the second property. Our second property is commutative law. It says that two rational numbers can be added in any order. What does it mean? Let us understand with an example. If A upon B and C upon D are two rational numbers, then A upon B plus C upon D is C upon D plus A upon B. Here we have reversed the order. It means that ulta pulta ek saman. You can remember this property as this punchline, ulta pulta ek saman. Now let us take an example where we have taken A upon B as 1 upon 2 and C upon D as 3 upon 4. Let us add these two numbers in two different orders. And here we have written left hand side and right hand side. Let us see what happens. Here we have done A upon B plus C upon D. Here 1 upon. So A upon B is 1 upon 2 and C upon D is 3 upon 4. Here we have done addition like the same process and answer. We will get answer as 5 upon 4. This we have converted into a mixed fraction. Now what we have done on the right hand side, we have added C upon D plus A upon B. So 3 upon 4 plus 1 upon 2. Again we have solved in a similar manner and get answer as 5 upon 4. And we have converted the same into a mixed fraction. So we have observed on both sides we are getting a same answer. So LHS is equal to RHS. So this is our second property. So till for today our class is over. Tomorrow we will continue with the properties only, and we will continue with the same exercise, that is exercise 1C. Now it's time for homework. Today's homework is, first you have to note down the notes in your copies or sheets, whatever you are having, and do exercise 1C, question number 7, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th part. These are the 4 parts which you have to do, and question number 12. And for question number 12, and you have to refer the previous day note for scan copy of exercise 1C and its answers that I have provided yesterday. So, not yesterday, exactly in the last class. So, you have to refer those notes, previous class notes, for exercise 1C and its answer for doing your homework. Thank you.